Amen. Amen.
And brother Danny took us out to shopping the other day. He said, if I got a wrong, I would look like a Filipino. Do I look like a Filipino?
Then.
My wife says that I'm a little bit too light-skinned for a Filipino. I got a bit dull.
Amen.
Let me say this before I get started this morning. I do want to say from the bottom of my heart that I thank you for letting us go and be a part of this week. We'll never be the same after coming here. I said many years ago, after my first mission trip, I said, going on a mission trip will forever change your life.
Yeah.
And even though it's not the first mission trip, it's still life-changing experience. Amen. And I can say, speaking for myself, we love this church. God can have great, great blessings to us. Just to get to hear you sing and fellowship and the Spirit of God. Now, if I could say one thing to you, church, don't lose the Spirit of God. Amen. You've got to touch God in your church. You've got to touch God in your ministry. That's more important than anything in this world. You take 10 people that's got to touch God, they do more for God than 1,000 people that don't have no God. And you got a good group of people. I'm amazed that now women to work for God. You ladies did a, and some of you men as well, did a lot of hard work yesterday for those kids. And I really appreciate the privilege of being here. Thank you for all the food. Thank you for all the fellowship. It's been a tremendous honor to be a part of this meeting this week. I thank Brother Danny for inviting me. Just thank God for letting you come. Amen.
Amen.
And honestly say, this morning I hope you pray. Would be better off than we can.
Amen.
I hope and pray we've done something this week to help you, to encourage you, to strengthen you. Just I hope and pray that our trip to the Philippines will be fruitful. More hearts, more lives, more ministry. And for God's glory. So again, just thank you. And so many of you, I may not get to see you personally. Before we leave today, but I want you to know that we really appreciate you and just thank God for the privilege to be able to worship. He would write poetry, different poems and things. He wrote this poem, this Resurrection Sunday, amen?
Amen.
And by the way, the fact that we're celebrating today a risen Savior, that is the one single thing that separates born-again Christians from all the religions of the world. You know that? No other religion in the world has a living Savior. We're the only one.
Amen.
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 Yeah.
But God said that he wanted man to be a living Right.